Dave arrives at the same building as he meets with the main record producer and his supposed friend, played by David Cross. Upon getting on the floor, everyone's really nice to Dave, offering him stuff as he passes by. I only say this because later, you know what, I'll show you. After getting to his office, Cross listens to Dave's CD.
My sweet love, if you die tonight, I'll wait on the other side to pull you through the abyss of death. And no more signs across these faded lines.
Let's talk about your song, Dave.
Well, as crazy as it sounds...
Your song sucks, Dave.
Came to me.
Song sucks, Dave.
Whoa! Got riff back on that one.
So Cross tells Dave that he sucks and fails at life because he's the rich asshole that loves to crush dreams. Seriously, he's a hair's breadth away of saying he loves to bludgeon puppies and kittens with sledgehammers. I have to admit, at least he's an honest prick. So as Dave walks out of the office, he asks one of Cross's assistants for the previously offered bottle of water just to be told basically to fuck off, and as he passes the girl with the muffins, he tries to take one just to have it pulled away from him.
Let me predict what happens next. Dave walks away defeated, and then walks outside just to have it start raining on him.
Hey!
Dave just said fuck you right back! Like a boss!
As Dave makes his way down to the lobby, Alvin, Simon, and Theodore are making their way down the tree in hopes to escape the building. This is something I meant to point out earlier, but the story was moving way too fast. I like how in this movie they actually make an attempt to make the chipmunks look like fucking chipmunks, not mutated rodent children. Well, after being threatened by bigger things in the lobby, they spot Dave and the basket of muffins and jump in to make an escape. Upon arriving home, Dave looks at the basket, and by the way, the chipmunks are hiding, then dumps the basket of pastries into the garbage. Being bummed, depressed, and dare I say a little pissed off, Dave chucks all of his music equipment outside, then sets in to watch a little TV. That's when the chipmunks start digging in the cabinets for food, making it a disaster in the process. Dave discovers them in his house and starts to go on a rampage trying to get them.
At one point, this happens. God damn it, do I have to get the list out again?
After all the fighting, Alvin drops a jar of popcorn on Dave's head.
You got knocked the fuck out!
After a few hours, Dave comes to find that the chipmunks can actually talk. After Dave asks a couple of questions because, well, if I found animals talking to me after being hit in the fucking head, that'd be my first instinct, the chipmunks introduce themselves.
Hello, I'm Simon the smart one. He's Alvin, the awesomest one.
And I'm Theodore.
Oh, nice to meet you. Now get out of my house.
But we talk.
Which only makes me want you out of my house that much more. It's creepy, unnatural, somewhat evil.
Are you serious? I'm a fucking demon.
Get bent!
After Dave tosses them outside, he starts to clean up the mess when suddenly he hears something.
Wait, you guys can sing too?
Dave decides to strike a deal that the chipmunks could stay and live with him if they were to sing his songs. They agree, but then Dave realizes that being pissed off and irrational was a bad idea because...
Hey, I was right about the rain thing. Although it came later, I'm awarding full points!
Upon settling in for the night, the boys start talking about Christmas. As Dave tries to settle into bed, he's suddenly hit with inspiration.
Want a plane that loops the loop. Loop. Hula hoop.
After a long night of work, Dave wakes up to a massive mess in his house. Despite that, Dave starts playing the ever-famed Chipmunks song with the boys singing along.
Now wait just a goddamn second! They just wrote the song! How the fuck did they learn the lyrics already?
Now, we turn our attention back to Cross. He learns Dave is downstairs waiting to show him the next big thing, but the chipmunks choke, making Dave look like an ass. He don't exactly have any nice words afterwards. After dropping the boys off at home, Dave heads to his day job as an advertising consultant. While trying to present projected sales figures for the whatever the hell it is product, he finds that the boys drew on his shit. But not before getting a phone call from Simon to tell him that both Theodore and Alvin had been sucked up into the vacuum cleaner, as well as now having water damage everywhere.
Oh great! Maybe while you're at it, you could burn down his house and then rape his mother, you fucking pillocks!
Because of the crap caused by the three rodents living with him, Dave is canned from his job. Dave basically goes off on a freakout tangent which causes Theodore to— OH COME THE FUCK ON!
Oh god damn it! Do they have to do this? It was already bad enough with the fucking fart jokes, but now you have to have actual physical shit?! How much fucking lower can they drive this goddamn movie down?!
It's a raisin, Dave.
Prove it.
Mm-hmm. Great! I'll never be able to eat raisins again! Goodbye, Raisin Bran! So long, Cinnamon Raisin Bagels! Sayonara, Trail Mix!
Thank you so much for going the Pink Flamingos route! John Waters would be so fucking proud!
Upon learning that What's-Your-Face is coming to dinner, Dave runs out to get food as the boys clean house. Well, sorta. Dave freezes the boys out of going to dinner with him and her name is what. Alvin gets the bright idea to try and get the two of them together. It goes about as good as you think.
Project.
Where's Al? Ow! Ow! My life is being sabotaged by talking chipmunks.
I have the same problem, if only with penguins.
You know what?
I'm not crazy, I swear.
You haven't changed at all.
Never trust a species that can't put a cap on its own reproductive functions. Hillbillies, I'm especially talking to you.
Upset, Dave contemplates taking the chipmunks back to the forest, but can't bring himself to do so. Meanwhile, realizing how bad they inadvertently screwed Dave over, the chipmunks head over to Cross's house and sing for him. The next day, Dave hears his song being played on the radio and finds that him and the chipmunks now have a music contract.
Now, if I saw three singing chipmunks, I would have responded like this. Fucking Jehovah's Witnesses. That is the last time I am drinking Mr. Clean. From now on, it's gonna be good old-fashioned window cleaner. Ugh, streak free.